Did you know that in the year 2000, Oakland County's overall African-American infant mortality rate of 25.2 per 1,000 live births put us behind countries such as Indonesia, Kazakhstan, and even North Korea? Now, that statistic, we all would agree, is unacceptable. In fact, it's obscene. Back then, I remember directing my health department to commit the resources, time, the staff, and a pilot program to reduce infant mortality in the African-American community in Oakland County. Today, the results are very rewarding, but still, there's room for improvement. The African-American infant mortality rate for the last 3 years has been cut by more than half to 10.4 per 1,000 live births. My health department's success in reducing infant mortality rates in the African-American community did not go unnoticed. It received statewide recognition. The Michigan Public Health Association bestowed its 2014 Public Health Community Achievement Award upon the county's health division for this initiative. So good work, George Miller and Kathy Forsley. Now I would like to update you on some major initiatives that we are reaching this year on key economic development programs. First, let me update you on the novel economic development approach that we announced 2 years ago. Back in 2013, we launched One Stop Ready, a program that shares and teaches the best practices and ideas and a proactive economic development. By focusing on when a company needs to open up and how government can, at all levels, can assist a company timely entrance into the market, will result in companies hiring faster, investing quicker, and impacting our economy sooner. Time is money, and the communities like Troy, who have reduced permitting time from weeks to days, the results are rolling in. One Stop Ready is only as strong as our local government partners, and by the end of this year, we'll have 21 of our cities and townships operating as One Stop Ready practitioners. Developers throughout the county say they're already noticing the difference. These tools have helped bring to Oakland County global companies like GKN in Auburn Hills, or a new recycling center in Pontiac, the new MJR Theater in Troy, and many more. One Stop Ready is a game changer. So good work, Matt Gibb, Irene Spanos, and Dan Hunter. Oakland County continues to see more and more signs that our economy is strengthening. Our equalization manager, Dave Heber, says that home mortgage foreclosures, once fluttering above 9,000 per year, are down to levels below the 2000 mark. Last year, there were about 1,900 foreclosures. Using 2002 and 2014 as bookends, Oakland County saw more than 61,000 home foreclosures. Oakland County is no stranger to helping those who are in distress. Through the work of our community home improvement team led by Carrie Reith in 2014, we successfully counseled and assisted more than 460 homeowners through this perilous process, helping them keep their home and their pride. Since the 2009 economic collapse, when Oakland County lost more than 60,000 jobs in that 1 year, our business community has pulled together and has added a net total of nearly 80,000 new jobs into our economy, thus lowering our unemployment rate from 13% during the depths of the Great Recession to 5.5% as we entered 2014. Yeah, we've got a report in the office that basically says when you reach 5% unemployment, that's considered full employment, so we're getting very close. Jobs are created by investment and growth, and Oakland County has seen plenty of both. The Oakland County One-Stop Shop Business Center witnessed small business loans triple from $7 million in 2012 to $22 million in 2013. The past 2 years, this active center, led by Greg Doyle, has found access to capital exceeding $52 million, creating hundreds of jobs and enabling nearly $30 million of loans for small and second-stage companies. And we're still reaching some milestones as we work to attract companies in the knowledge-based economy here in Oakland County. Back in 2004, we launched Emerging Sectors. Now, that's our signature program to attract high-paying jobs that are sustainable for decades to come. We discovered in the process, while we were looking at emerging sectors, the top 10 sectors for future growth in Oakland County are all part of this knowledge-based economy: healthcare, IT, finance, nanotechnology, That's just naming a few. Well, I'm proud to say that we are on the cusp of reaching the $3 billion investment mark with our emerging sectors categories. That's $3 billion, that's with a B. Well over 310 companies from within these emerging sectors, these 10 sectors, are now helping us toward our goal of diversifying the economy while creating or retaining more than 50,000 jobs since inception. I really think that's a game changer, folks, that emerging sectors, and we're really pressing that one. One of our greatest strengths is our global presence. Some of these stats may amaze you. Oakland County is home to 57% of the global Fortune 500 and now hosts more than 1,020 foreign-owned multinational companies from 38 different countries around the world. This accomplishment prompted Deputy Director Aaron Buckmeyer from the Select USA at the U.S. Department of Commerce to remark, quote, "Oakland County has one of the best economic development teams in the country," period, end quote. I would agree. The excellent team will be an important part of the Select USA Summit in Washington later this spring. Healthcare continues to be one of our most robust sectors. And Medical Main Street, which we kicked off back in 2008, is about to reach a $1 billion investment mark. Nearly 50 companies have invested $1 billion to create or retain 8,000 jobs in this burgeoning sector. Last year at this time, I announced an initiative that would build on our strength as a technology leader. That initiative, called Tech 248, is a branding and business development program aimed at harvesting the power of over 2,000 tech companies in the county and market our county as a global technology hub. The estimated expansion of this sector projects that Oakland County will add a new technology company every 30 days. And we want to continue the upward trend, and Tech 248 will be the point of the spear leading our global marketing endeavors. Tech 248 will work with our existing companies, our colleges and universities to open up the paths to the most needed advanced tech jobs. We learned the skill sets needed for these jobs when we conducted our first skills needs assessment back in 2009. Our partners in workforce development, such as Oakland Community College and its Chancellor, Timothy Meyer, have already created the programs from that assessment to help train tomorrow's workforce. And by the way, Tim, I know you're here. Congratulations on your 50th anniversary as a school in our community, Oak CC. A year ago, I announced the creation of our Connected Vehicle Task Force to implement a plan to make Oakland County the first American county with a countywide connected vehicle ecosystem. The task force is chaired by my good friend Fred Nader, founder and president of AutoTech Technology Development, and rounding out the committee is Elena Farnsworth, CEO of Mobile Company, and Paul Halterman, vice president and managing director of IHS Automotive Advisory Services. Now, Gregory Kruger of Lados and several leading companies are here, such as here, that's the name of the company, HERE, Arada, PacGrid, and others are also participating in this task force. What they've accomplished in just 1 year is nothing short of incredible. The task force's primary mission is to prove there is a viable business model for implementing connected vehicle technology and infrastructure, and how the private sector can manage the costs and the maintenance of the technology being developed for tomorrow's automobile. Task Force joined forces with the U.S. Department of Transportation as an integral member of the affiliated test bed in Detroit. And in September, at the Intelligent Transport Systems, or ITS World Congress in Detroit, the Task Force demonstrated how RSU technology can be used to determine a vehicle's location and completed real-time demonstrations of a vehicle's position to within a matter of inches. Now, this was something that had never been done before, and it was the first step in building the business case of a countywide connected vehicle ecosystem. The year ahead is full of promise, too. Much of the global research in connected and autonomous vehicles is happening right here in Oakland County. And this task force, and through the task force, the county will position itself as one of the leaders in converting research into reality.